Everybody, to 8pm last night, there were just over 95,000 tests done in New South Wales, and it's really important, as we always say, to keep those testing rates high. To 8pm yesterday, there were 262 cases of community transmission, with at least 50 of those infectious in the community during that time. And as we've seen in the last few days, the numbers are bouncing around a bit, but clearly those numbers, and I urge everybody to please stick to the rules, follow the health advice, and only leave home if you absolutely have to. Unfortunately, overnight there was one death of a woman in her 80s who was not vaccinated, and Dr. McAnulty will provide further information about that. In relation to the virus, Canterbury-Bankstown local government area still remains the epicentre of the most cases. Obviously, all local government suburbs within the Canterbury-Bankstown area and adjoining areas are under risk of transmission. It's again creating the highest number of cases, and as Deputy Commissioner Warbors will outline, that has been the focus also of police compliance with extra presence on the ground, making sure people are doing the right thing. On a more positive note, health experts advise us that if people in the Georges River local government area come forward for higher rates of testing in the next few days, that local government area is likely to be taken out of an area of concern. So can I please urge everybody who lives in the Georges River local government area, especially in those suburbs adjoining the local government areas of concern, please come out and get tested if you have the mildest of symptoms. That will give the health experts confidence to take the Georges River local government area out of those areas of concern. And congratulations to people in that area who've been following the advice, doing the right thing, and have seen a reduction in the number of cases. Regrettably, however, there are 12 suburbs in the Penrith local government area that will be now listed as an area of concern and will be subjected to those harsher restrictions that we've imposed on those 8 local government areas. Dr. McAnulty will read what those 12 suburbs are, but they're clearly suburbs that are boundaries to those other 8 local government areas. And we want to make sure that we stem the tide of the virus seeping into those additional communities. And as I said, Dr. McAnulty will read what those 12 suburbs are. And we ask residents from 5 o'clock this afternoon to adhere to the additional restrictions placed upon them. Pleasingly, New South Wales now has made sure that there are 4.4 million jabs in arms. Now, that is positive. We're doing really well in terms of increasing the number of people getting vaccinated every day. And can I urge everybody who hasn't had at least one dose of the vaccine to come forward and get vaccinated. Every adult should be coming forward and getting vaccinated, and we urge everybody to please do that. As you all know, in Homebush today, we're focusing on any worker who works in supermarkets or face-to-face food retail. There are thousands of people who've already booked to come in and get their jab today, but it's also allowable for people to walk in today. If you want a jab, especially if you work in frontline food services, please come forward today to Homebush and get a jab. The vaccination centre there is open till 4pm. And whilst we do have a couple of thousand bookings already, there is capacity for people to come forward. It's a rainy day. If you don't have symptoms and you're not in isolation, you're not a close contact, and you're not someone of concern, please come forward and get the jab. Can I also stress again how important it is for us to fight this outbreak through the lockdown, through everybody doing the right thing, but also through getting vaccinated. And they are the two tools we have to reduce the case numbers and look forward to a future which has fewer restrictions. And I really, really urge everybody to stay at home unless they absolutely have to. And secondly, of course, come forward and get the jab if they haven't. Dr. McAnulty will now provide the health update, and Deputy Commissioner Warbois will talk about police compliance efforts. Thank you.
Thanks, Premier, and good morning, everyone. There were 262 locally acquired cases of COVID-19 reported in New South Wales to the 24 hours to 8 o'clock last night. There were also 6 overseas acquired cases to 8 o'clock last night. There were 95,480 tests reported until 8 o'clock last night, compared to the previous day's total of 108,449. In terms of cases in hospital, we are seeing large numbers of people with COVID admitted to hospital. There are 362 cases admitted to hospital, with 58 in intensive care and 24 requiring ventilation. Of the 58 cases in intensive care, 5 are in their 20s, 7 in their 30s, 4 in their 40s, 17 in their 50s, 7 in their 60s, 15 in their 70s, and 3 in their 80s. So young people are certainly getting caught up with this disease. Of the 58 people in ICU, 54 were not vaccinated, 3 had received their first dose of AstraZeneca, and 1 had received their first dose of Pfizer vaccine. Sadly, as the Premier mentioned, New South Wales Health has been notified of the death of a person with COVID-19 who's a woman in her 80s who was a resident of the Wyoming Residential Aged Care Facility in Summerhill, and she died in Royal Prince Alfred Hospital. She tested positive for COVID-19 on the 1st of August and was admitted to hospital that day. We extend our sincere sympathies to the family and loved ones of that person. She was not vaccinated. We've had positive sewage detections in Dubbo and low levels in Mudgee. So we're asking people to come forward for testing in those communities. There's no known cases in those communities, so we need to be extra vigilant. Wherever we see sewage in communities without known cases, so that please come forward for testing if you have even the mildest of symptoms, if you live in Dubbo or Mudgee. The Premier mentioned additional restrictions for 12 suburbs in the city of Penrith. Now we've seen the front of the epidemic move into parts of Penrith adjacent to the areas in Western Sydney and southwestern Sydney. So we're concerned, and the additional restrictions will help contain that outbreak emerging there. The suburbs affected, which are adjacent to Cumberland and Liverpool LGAs, Cadens, Claremont Meadows, Colleton, Erskine Park, Kemps Creek, Kingswood, Mount Vernon, North St Mary's, Orchard Hills, Oxley Park, St Clair and St Mary's. In line with the restrictions currently in place in Blacktown, Campbelltown, Canterbury-Bankstown, Cumberland, Fairfield, Georges River, Liverpool and Parramatta LGAs, people in these 12 suburbs must only obtain food or other goods and services and exercise within 5 kilometres of their home. You can't travel to other areas of work outside those areas unless you're an authorised worker. Masks must be worn whenever you're outdoors, except in a common outdoor area of a backyard apartment, for example. And masks do not have to be worn while you're in a car with other members of your family. Thanks very much.